Another healthy dish for the new year, Filipino salad. So, Filipino, how Filipino is it?
I guess if you sang Bahay Kubo, you'd find all these vegetables in there. So, that's as Filipino as it'll get. This is really what you call the salad that I put together from the leftovers in my fridge. Okay. So, it can
quickly
really
run through it.
Anything and everything. Tomatoes, we always have tomatoes. Onions, we've got onions. We've got okra, eggplant. We've got, what is this?
Talbos.
Ng kamote. We've got some green mangoes. We've got some ducks, salted eggs. Oh, and some lato or arosep that we find in the market. It's in season.
Singkamas.
At talong.
Okra.
And then we've got okra.
And of
we've
course,
got some lettuce that we want to add.
So I noticed that you grilled some of the the tomatoes, the
optional
onions, and
it's
and
optional
the
for you to do that.
And the okra.
But then I thought that maybe, you know, for the added texture and spice to
blanched
the salad,
the
blanch this and everything, and then you grilled some of the okra.
Yeah.
You could actually just blanch most of them if you want.
Okay, but what you're going to show us now is the
we've got a variation
salad dressings.
Of three dressings. Okay.
Variations.
You know, we often get accused that we don't have too many dressings in our cuisine. Okay, and the most traditional one that we know is the sugar, vinegar, peppercorn
that you put in the cucumber.
Yeah, which
and
is
even
nice,
in the eggplant. Right?
Yeah, which is really quite nice if you're asking me, and it and really is something that we can call our very own. However, you know, there are many other Philippine ingredients that we can put together to come up with a dressing, which is a take on certain dressings. Okay,
one
is an invention of mine. It was originally a honeyed patis dressing.
Honeyed patis dressing.
Right. In which case we have, as of late, you know, in the restaurant, we're constantly creating new dishes. And one day they decided to add some dalandan juice to that. And so we've got a honeyed dalandan dressing, which should go quite well with all these vegetables.
Mm-mm.
And so we'll show you that right now, which is very easy. Okay, so we've got some fresh dalandan juice. You want to use fresh.
Mm-hmm.
Don't want to really use.
Then you have patis.
You know, the bottle, and you have patis, but then, you know, I don't want to be too.
But this one I thought was darker patis.
No, it's honey.
Or fish sauce. It's honey.
Honey. To cut the saltiness.
Yes.
Of.
And those are really mean chilies.
Yes, this would be optional.
Mean chilies.
But then again,
of course.
You know,
it's
we
Christmas.
We want to spice up our new year. Want some fireworks in there. And so, we've got a...
You can imagine how what it tastes like, no? The landan.
Yeah.
You have patis, you have honey, and you
one
have
thing,
chili seeds or chili peppers.
One thing with the recipes I've developed, I don't want to be too complicated about the ingredients and procedures.
I noticed. And easy to get.
Yeah.
Easy to get ingredients.
Uh-huh, not very expensive.
Yes.
Very easy to understand. Quite popular, you know, in terms of its appeal.
And then this is something that you can store and keep in the refrigerator and just bring it out every time you have these ingredients.
Then again, fresh oranges have a tendency to go sort of flat after a while.
So you just have to really take it fresh.
I wouldn't do that.
And then, so how do we...
So if you have some nice silver lying around, you know, some
and
dressings and all, I just want to pour it here because then we want to offer our guests a choice of dressings.
Okay. Can I smell it?
Oh, sure.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. One down.
So one down, two to go.
What do you call that?
Honey dalandan dressing.
Honey dalandan dressing.
Mm-hmm.
One down, two to go. And this one is more or less the thing that I do.
Yeah, the
pepper,
the Tagalog dressing,
the sugar,
the vinegar. But in this case, you
what
know, let's you add, s- a li- okay. add a little bagoong balayan to that one.
And no chilies.
Okay. Well, you know, we have the chilies in there. We have the heat coming from that dressing. And so, you know, we want to slow down on that area.
So it's a vinegar that gives the liquid for the entire dressing?
Do you realize that we are probably a country that enjoys the variety of vinegars?
I know. You know, I now go to the supermarket. The Filipino-made vinegars now have different kinds of types of vinegar. Sugar cane, coconut. And is that an indication that they're beginning to see the various vinegar, various things that vinegar can be drawn from?
Yes.
And these are mainly sugarcane, coconut,
palm, coconut, pineapple. You can even have pineapple vinegars as well.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Whereas Italy has what? Balsamic.
That one has become very popular of late.
And a white wine vinegar.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. So that is, this is what kind of vinegar? Just ordinary vinegar.
This is...
Sugar. Cane?
No, paumbong.
Paumbong, okay.
It's palm.
Okay.
Palm vinegar, okay. Then, of course, you know, you just want to make tancha. How much sweetness or sourness you want to your dressing, and... I put about, 2 to 3 tablespoons to this one.
Okay? Tablespoons of sugar?
Yes.
Okay. And then this is the balayan.
And this is bagoong. The balayan.
This is the one that's practically with, this is not shrimp, no? This is fish.
This is fish. Fish. Okay. Balayan comes from the
Batangas.
Balayan. Province of Batangas in Balayan.
Exciting, getting to be exciting. Mm-hmm.
If you wanted to throw some chopped onions in there, you could. Again, if you wanted a little more heat, you could also put some chilies in there. But I cut the saltiness of the bagoong by mixing
sugar.
It with sugar and the vinegar. Because then otherwise, if you had, say, foreign guests, you know, they don't really... have much of a liking for bagoong, and so like kare-kare would be a dish that would not appeal to them very much, like it would to us.
And so, how much of the pepper? That's peppercorn.
Yes, this is peppercorn. You know how Filipinos like to use crushed pepper instead of the fine pepper, and so in this case,
you buy peppercorn, then you crush them.
Yeah, or you could. You could use a pepper mill, in fact, if you wanted to. And that's where the heat will come from. You know, sometimes the heat from the peppercorns is also very appealing, you know, versus that coming from a chili, perhaps. So let's give this one a taste and tell me whether you want more sugar in there.
Excuse me. It's the vinegar that's really very strong.
For you.
For me,
but so
I can taste I can taste the pepper and the sweetness.
So do you want me to add more sugar to
that one? I'm fine.
Actually, it's quite nice.
I'm fine. I can take it.
You have to remember, even as the flavors here are very strong, that you're really using this as a dressing.
For all of these, so it's going to be...
So it'll, you know, it'll taper off. Okay?
Yeah, taste. So there's another.
So we've got dressing number two.
I tried this bagoong balayan on a salad as a dressing by using puso ng saging.
Oh, yeah. Yes, because you know, puso ng saging, there is a traditional dish from Batangas and Quezon. It's called tinumis. It's really like a, it's really banana blossom salad cooked in vinegar.
Yeah.
So it should go quite well.
Yeah. Okay. And the third one. So we are learning three salad dressings today.
Salad
and these
dressings
are the things that you will put in that salad dressing. And it's just easy to get. It's in your vegetable crisper area of your refrigerator.
And so...
And this one...
On to our last dressing. And so even as these are not traditional dressings, because like I said, there is an absence of salad dressings in our cuisine. And so, of course, in keeping with the modern demands of today's eating healthy food and vegetables,